Otar Chiladze was a Georgian writer. Born in Signangi in Kakheti province in 1933, his elder brother being the writer Tamas Chiladze, author of The Bruegel Moon. He graduated at Tbilisi State University, earning a degree in journalism in 1956. He began publishing in 1959, writing several books of poetry. His famous novels include The Iron Theatre and Everyone That Findeth Me. In 1993, he was awarded the State Prize of Georgia for contributions to literature. He died at Tbilisi in 2009 and was buried at the Mtamsinda Pantheon of Writers and Public Figures. In 1973, he published his first prose, A Man Was Going Down the Road, a name based on a children's game, which we shall be reviewing today. His story takes place in ancient Colchis, and tells us of the arrival of Phrixus upon the back of a ram floating in the sea, and him being taken to ancient Vanni, the capital of Colchis, and taken in by King Aetes, eventually marrying his daughter Calciope. This being an adaptation of the story of the Golden Fleece, the author's new characters don't get much to do, at least initially, and they get introduced so we can see them, I guess? This includes the wine merchant Bacchus, the Babylonian prostitute Malalo and her many daughters, or a husband and wife who keep having a multitude of children, but who never age, and are much younger than their offspring. And I'm sorry to spoil the endless praise for this book, but someone had to say it. It's not very good. The author slows down the book immensely by having mundane actions be over-described at great length using a never-ending tidal wave of parables and allegories that leave the story itself as a lengthy slog, going as far as delivering such lengthy diversions 4 times on a single page. Almost like the author wants to show off just how darn clever he is and how deep he can be with his allegories. Look and be amazed! The plot of the book is also confusing. The author jumps around and skips immense stretches of time, and then has to put the already sluggish plot on hold so he can go back and relate the past history of a character he just introduced for the first time, but who's always had a relation to the main characters. And the big plot of the Great King Minos is so convoluted, it requires an orphan foundling set adrift on a ram to not only not drown, but to be rescued, accepted into Van society, and marry into the royal family, and have sons that Minos can use to get the golden hide. A plan that takes 2 generations to come to fruition, and which Minos just expects to happen all on its own without any interference or guidance whatsoever. And then the first third of the book ends, and the quality takes a major nosedive. When Chiladze had to deal with the characters of Euripides' tragedy, he was under at least some obligation to have something happen, and to bother to establish his characters. But then, after the first part ends, the plot of the Argonautica is swiftly abandoned, all of its characters removed from the book for good, and the focus shifts to made-up character Pharnaos. Now, Pharnaos is probably some sort of avatar for Chiladze because he is used for 2 things. Incessantly moaning about not being able to change his destiny, while doing nothing to change his destiny. Vainly trying to come off as tortured, and to spout dozens of pages of philosophy to further impress the reader about how knowledgeable the author is, and how deep his protagonist is. The fact he is devoting 2/3 of the book to this endlessly whining, lethargic, mopey loser, while the characters of Euripides get 1/3 and never get resolution in the book, might speak about the young budding author's vanity, but I could be wrong. What is certain is, the second Pharnaos is born, and the Argonauts are left behind a mere memory. The lethargy of Pharnaos and the endless parable peddling of the narrator combine to make the already slow book take on the pace of your average glacier, and the ending is unsatisfying as well.